Hello and welcome to Ferris Sports Update. I'm your host, Rob Bentley, and thanks for tuning in. On today's show, we'll highlight our Bulldogs in the pros as we talk Ferris State hockey. We'll celebrate the 25th anniversary of the 1995 Ferris State football national semifinal team, and we'll talk the history and tradition of Ferris State track and field across country. We'll start first, though, with Bulldog hockey and joined by the play-by-play voice of Bulldog hockey, Harrison Watt. Harrison, welcome to the show.
Rob, thanks for having me today.
Bulldogs in the pros, a great place to start here is we're in the Stanley Cup Finals and a pair with Bulldog ties. Derek Lalonde, an assistant coach with the Tampa Bay Lightning, former Bulldog assistant, and Brian Garlock, who got his start as a Zamboni driver, ice arena worker here at Ferris State, both right there in the mix with the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Oh, it's a great story. And obviously, this being shot before, Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final, it's been a really compelling playoff. I think, to be honest, this has probably been one of the hardest Stanley Cups to win because they got to go through so much more just to get back, and then they had an extra round in there too. So for Tampa to be where they are today, it's a testament to how good of a team they are. And Coach Lalonde has had success at every level he's been at. He was a great coach in the ECHL in Toledo. He was a great coach at the college level. He was a great coach at the AHL level with the Iowa Wild, where he coached another Bulldog in the pros, Gerald Mayhew. And I think he's working his way into being in the conversation to be an NHL head coach soon. I mean, we're at a point where we could soon have three, maybe four guys in the NHL as head coaches or head and assistant coaches, and no different for Brian Garlock. Those positions are tough to do, those video positions. Tampa's a team that relies heavily on preparation, stuff like video, stuff like analytics, and Brian Garlock does an excellent job with that. So Tampa's very lucky to have them both, and we're lucky to have them both as former Bulldogs.
Great story. Brian Garlock kind of got his start in hockey following John Cooper, who had his camp when he was the head coach at Texarkana here at the Ava Glavin Ice Arena.
Yeah, it's a really great story, and obviously Coach Cooper got great ties all around the area. It's a top-notch organization, and one that, you know, it has more Bulldog ties. You think about Steve Eisman being the GM there. He moves from Tampa Bay to Detroit. Now he's got another Bulldog alum in Jeff Blashill. So he's used to it. He knows what they're capable of, and I just think it's excellent. I think the NHL is about to fill up with Bulldog alums. We've seen it with some other teams that Ferris State competes against, like Bowling Green, and I think this is about to be Ferris State's time to be big in the NHL.
Obviously, the Stanley Cup, the most prestigious trophy out there in the sports world, and one Bulldog that's got his name on there four times, Chris Kunitz, who's kind of the highlighted alum here for Ferris State that also won an Olympic gold medal.
Yeah, that's a career that it's really interesting because he was willing to do whatever it took just to get to the next level. He ended up in Anaheim and became a big story on the Anaheim Stanley Cup team. A lot of people kind of forget because he had all the success with Sidney Crosby in Pittsburgh in recent years, but he was a really key cog to his first Stanley Cup with a bunch of younger guys, guys like Ryan Getzlaff and everybody back in 2007. And then when he was traded over to Pittsburgh in 2009, I think that was the turning point for that Pittsburgh team. They needed a guy exactly like him, and he did exactly what they needed. And I still think to this day he's one of the biggest reasons they ended up winning that first Stanley Cup and the few after that. He obviously scored a lot of big goals, a lot of really exciting goals. But above all that, an excellent guy, a guy that deserved to be on the Olympic team. Canada's an excellent Olympic hockey team. They were that year. So for Chris Kunitz, it was really a storied career, and continuing it now in the front office with the Chicago Blackhawks, another great organization. So he's been an alum that kind of paved the way, I think, for some of the rest of them that have come now.
Obviously, earlier this summer he was named as one of the inductees for the 2020 Bulldog Hall of Fame class. Unfortunately, that event has been postponed, but we'll be joined in that class by Jeff Blashill, who you mentioned earlier, the head coach of the Detroit Red Wings, and another Ferris State alum.
No-brainers. I mean, these are two of the great guys in the NHL. You know, Jeff Blashill's great because he came on at such a challenging time for the Red Wings when they had an aging team. They were at a weird place. They changed the GM. Steve Yzerman comes in, who I think is probably the most credible voice in Detroit sports and maybe even in hockey right now. And he continues to put his weight behind Jeff Blashill because he can see what the young guys are doing in terms of development. I think Jeff is excellent in that way. And as this rebuild continues to get going, I think he's the right guy for the job in Detroit. Steve Yzerman certainly thinks so, and just like I tell everybody, if it's good enough for Steve Yzerman, it's good enough for you.
Obviously, this past year, more than 40 former Ferris State hockey players either playing or coaching at all levels of professional hockey, both here in the United States and overseas.
Yeah, they're everywhere. we've got guys flooding in the ECHL. It seems like every year two, three, or four guys will sign in the East Coast League. Coaching-wise, you've got guys in the USHL like Cody Chupp who have really made a name for themselves. In the North American League, Justin DiMartino's done an excellent job. Recently, Seth Appert moved on from the USA National Team Development Program. He's in the American League now, and I think that's another guy that's probably going to be in the NHL sooner rather than later. The jobs in Rochester, typically where Seth is now with the Rochester Americans, typically those guys have a good chance to move their way up. And Seth is another good young coach, and it just speaks volumes to the depth of coaching that seems to come out of this area. And I think, you know, to be sure, again, there are going to be three or four either head coaches or assistant coaches in the NHL very soon that are Bulldog alums, and that's a pretty big number out of a school like this, and I think that a lot of them are going to last a really long time.
Obviously, one of our more recent alums here, Gerald Mayhew, had a chance in the NHL this past season with the Minnesota Wild and has really developed into one of the top players in the AHL over the past couple of years.
Well, he was the AHL's MVP. He was the AHL's leading goal scorer. He was, like, not even in the AHL for most of the season because he just kept getting called up because he was so good. So he played something like eight less games than the second-place goal scorer, and he outdid him by, like, five goals. I mean, Gerald was scoring at a crazy pace. Every time I turned something on, he scored a goal. If he had played a full season in the AHL, he would have scored 50 goals, which doesn't happen in the AHL almost ever. So he definitely earned his NHL call-up, scored twice this year. He made it into the NHL bubble with the Minnesota Wild, who had an early exit, but I think he's got a future in the NHL. I don't know if it's going to be with Minnesota, but they seem pretty keen on him. He's got another year on that contract up there, so I'm sure he'll get his chances. That's another team that's kind of in a rebuild, so there will be ice time available, and Gerald's one guy that when he sees a door open, he's going to go run right through it.
Obviously, a lot of these guys that have played at Ferris State have had an opportunity to move on. How much does it help having a coaching staff, Bob Daniels, Drew Famulak, that have been around for a long time? You got Mark Kaufman, a former NHL assistant, and Dave Sensor, who worked in the Blackhawk organization.
Well, I think the credibility of knowing what you're getting from Ferris State people, you know that when you get someone that was coached by Bob Daniels and Dave Sensor, Mark Kaufman and Drew Famulak, that you're getting somebody that's learned to play the game the right way, that's learned to be the right kind of man, that's learned to be a pro. Rarely do you ever see anyone come through this program that isn't all of those things if they're going to make it to the NHL level or even the AHL level. So I think it's easy to sign someone from Ferris State just because the level of credibility you get when you hear from, oh, this person was coached by Bob Daniels. Anywhere you go, everywhere I go at least, the only person anyone wants to talk to is Coach Daniels or Coach Sensor or all of them. So I know there's credibility there, and they definitely, I think, help elevate these young men into their pro careers.
Well, Harrison, thanks for being with us today as we highlight some of our Bulldogs in the pros, and looking forward to hopefully having a great hockey season coming up here this year.
Thanks for having me.
We'll be back with more Ferris Sports Update right after this.